Welcome everybody to my channel today. Today we will discuss on trigonometric ratios of some specific angles. Okay, let us start.
Up to class 10 level, our specific angles are 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, and 90 degree. Sine, cos, and last part. Here I am discussing the method to remember the value. There is no mathematical derivation. After making the way to remember these values, next I will go for derive the value. Okay? For sine, write this sequence: root over 0 by 4, this is root over 1 by 4, root over of 2 by 4, root over of 3 by 4, root over of 4 by 4. Why I am writing this? There is no scientific reason behind it. Just I am writing it as a sequence which will help us to remember the value. Okay. So 0 by 4 is 0, its square root is 0. So I get sine 0 degree is 0. Next, square root of 1 by 4, this is half. So I get sine 30 degree is half. Now root over of 2 by 4, this can be thought of as root over of 1 by 2 because 2 cancel 4. Then it becomes 1 by root 2. So I get sine 45 degree is 1 by root 2. Next, root over of 3 by 4, we can write it as root over of 3 by 2, and as 4 by 4 is 1, so I get sine 90 degree is 1. So finally we get sine 0 degree is 0, sine 30 degree half, sine 40 by 1 by root 2, sine 60 root 3 by 2, and sine 90 is 1. For cosine, write this sequence in the reverse order. First write 1, then write root 3 by 2, then write 1 by root 2, then write half, then write 0. So what do we get? We get cos 0 degree 1, cos 30 root 3 by 2, cos 40 by 1 by root 2, cos 60 half, and cos 90 0. We know for any angle the ratio of its sine and cosine is 10. So we get value of 10 in this way: 0 division 1. So we get 0. Next, 1 by 2 division root 3 by 2, we get 1 by root 3. Next, 1 by root 2 division 1 by root 2 gives us 1. 2 by 2 division 1 by 2 gives us root 3, and 1 division 0 is undefined. So we write UD. So what do we get? We get tan 0 degree 0, tan 30 1 by root 3, tan 40 by 1, tan 60 root 3, and tan 90 undefined. Next, cosec. Cosec is reciprocal of sine, we know. So cosec 0 will be 1 division 0, reciprocal of 0, which is undefined. Next, cosec 30, this will be 1 division half, so we get 2. cosec 45, this will be 1 division 1 by root 2. So ultimately gives us root 2. This is 1 division root 3 by 2. So this gives 2 by root 3. This is 1 division 1. Okay, it gives us 1. So what we get finally? Cosec 0 undefined, cosec 32, cosec 45 root 2, cosec 60 2 by root 3, and cosec 91. Similarly, we get sec. Sec is reciprocal of cos. So sec 0 will be 1 division 1, so finally get 1. This is 1 division root 3 by 2, so we get 2 by root 3. This is 1 division 1 by root 2, so we get root 2. Next, 1 division half, so we get 2. This is 1 division 0, therefore undefined. Sec 90 is undefined because sec 90 is 0. Next, cot 0. Cot is reciprocal of 10, so we get here 1 division 0, which is undefined. Next, 1 division 1 by root 3, this is root 3. Cot 45, 1 division 1, this is 1. Cot 60, 1 division root 3, which is 1 by root 3. And tan 90 is undefined. Cot 90 will be, cot 90 can be thought of as cos 90 by sin 90. What is cos 90? Cos 90 is 0, sin 90 1. So you can think it as 0 division 1, so it is 0. So finally we get cot 0 undefined, cot 30 root 3, cot 40 by 1, cot 60 1 by root 3, and cot 90 0. So in this way we have to practice several times to form such a table which gives us trigonometric ratios of these 5 standard angles. 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree. Next I am going to prove these values geometrically. Okay. That can also be asked in your exam paper. First, trigonometric ratios of 30 degree and 60 degree. For this, we have to consider an equilateral triangle. Say ABC is an equilateral triangle having length of each side a unit. Next, we draw a perpendicular from A to BC, which meet BC at, say, D. So right here, ABC be an equilateral angle having length of each side A units, that is AB equals to BC equals to CA equals to A units. We draw AB perpendicular to BC. Now, triangle ADB, this will be congruent to triangle ABC. Why? Look here, right angle equal, hypotenuse, hypotenuse equal because equilateral, being equilateral triangle is all the sides are of equal length and then AD is their common side. So by RHS congruency, triangle ADB is congruent to triangle ADC. RHS congruency. This gives us DB equals to BC, which is half BC, that is a by 2 units. Now from triangle ADB, AD square will be equals to AB square minus BD square. AB is A and BD is A by 2. So this will become 3A square by 4. This is AD square. Therefore, AD will be equals to root 3A by 2 units. So write this here. Root 3A by 2. This is AB. Now, I am erasing all this. Look, angle BAD equals to angle CAD. CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangles, and both of them equal to half of angle BAC. Half of 60 degrees, because being an angle of an equal triangle, each angle must be of measure 60 degrees. Half of 60 degrees means 30 degrees. So I get angle BAD is 30 degrees. Now from triangle ATB, sine 30 degrees, that means sine of angle BAD. We have shown BAD is 30 degree. Now, where I am calculating sine of this angle, then BD will be perpendicular, because the side opposite to the angle concerned is perpendicular, and hypotenuse is always AB, because this is opposite to the right angle ADB. So sine angle BAD will be BD by AB. What is length of BD? BD is A by 2, because D is midpoint of BC. So BD is A by 2 as well as BC is A by 2. So this will be A by 2 by A. This is half. And look at your table. There I have written that sin 30 is half. Okay. After getting sin 30, similarly we can find cos 30. Cos 30 means cos of angle BAD. When I am writing cos curly brown here, so AD will be base and AB is hypotenuse. So this will be AD by AB. AD is root 3A by 2, AB is A, so this will become root 3 by 2. So we get cos 30 root 3 by 2. Next, tan 30. Tan of angle BAD. Tangent turned permanently black, so P by B. P is BD and B is AD. So this will be BD by AD. BD is A by 2, AD is root 3 A by 2, so ultimately gives 1 by root 3. So in similar way, you can find the rest of the three ratios, that is cosec 30, sec 30, cot 30. So we have calculated all the six ratios for the angle 30 degree. Next, let us find trigonometric ratios of the angle 60 degree. Now, in triangle ABD, we have angle ABD is 60 degrees, because it is an angle of an equilateral triangle. This angle is of measure 60 degrees. So therefore, from triangle ADB, sine 60 degrees, that is sine angle ABD, when the angle concerned is ABD, then the side opposite to ABD, that is AD, AD will be considered as perpendicular, AB is hypotenuse, and BD will be base. So some people have perpendicular by hypotenuse, so this will be AD by AB. What is AD? AD is root 3 A by 2. What is AB? This is A. So I get root 3 by 2. Look at the table, there I have written already that sin 60 is root 2. Next, cos 60 degree. Cos angle ABD. curly brown hair, this will be BT by AB. BT is A by 2, AB is A, so this becomes half. Cos 60 is half, then tan 60. Tan of angle ABD. Tangent of this angle will be perpendicular by base, that is AD by BD. What is AD? AD is root 3 A by 2. What is BD? BD is A by 2. So we get root 3. So in this way you can also find cosec 60 degrees, sec 60 degrees and cos 60 degrees. So we have calculated trigonometric ratios of two standard angles, 30 degree and 60 degree. Next, let us find trigonometric ratios of the angle 45. For this, let us consider an isosceles right triangle. Here AB equals to BC and angle ABC is 90 degrees. We consider the length of the equal sides be A angles. So write ABC be triangle ABC be a right triangle in which angle ABC equals to 90 degree and AB equals to BC equals to A units. Then AC square equals to AB square plus BC square by Pythagoras theorem. So this will be A square plus A square, that is 2A square. Therefore AC will be root 2 times A. Root 2 times A. Now look, as AB equals BC, therefore we can write angle BAC equals to angle BCA. Reason is as AB equals to BC, because we know the theorem, angles opposite to equal sides of a triangle are of equal measure. Now as angle ABC is 90 degrees, so the remaining, sum of the remaining angles must be 90 degrees. So write here, but angle BAC plus angle BCA equals to 90 degree. Reason is, since angle ABC is 90 degree. Now, sum of the angles is 90 degree and their measures are equal. So, measure of each angle will be half of 90 degree, that is 45 degree. So, we get both the angles are of measure 45. Now, I am erasing this. From triangle ABC, sine 45 degree, that is sine angle AC, this will be AB by AC. What is AB? AB is A, AC is root 2A. So this becomes ultimately 1 by root 2. Look at the table, there I have written already sine 45 degree is 1 by root 2. Next, cos 45 degree. Cos of angle ACB, ACB, then BC by AC. BC is A, AC is root 2A. This is also 1 by root 2. Next, tan 45 degree. That is tan angle ACB. This will be AB by BC. A by A equals to 1. So in the same way you can also find cosec 45 degree, sec 45 degree and cot 45 degree. So we have found the trigonometric ratios of 45 degree also. Now two angles remain, 0 degree and 90 degree. this, let us consider a general triangle, general right triangle ABC. Right angle at B and let angle ACB is of major theta. So right, let triangle ABC be a right triangle at B and angle ACB equals to theta. Now we have to observe something. When theta tends to 0 degree, then point A moves towards point B. Then point A moves towards point B. Length of AC becomes almost equal to length of BC, and as a subsequence, length of AB becomes 0. So when theta tends to 0, then these three facts will occur, and as a consequence, and then now first write sin theta. What is sin theta here? Sin theta is AB by AC and cos theta is BC by AC. So when theta tends to 0 degree, then sin theta tends to AB tends to 0 and AC will have some definite length, obviously different from 0. So sin theta will tend to 0 and cos theta, this will tend to AC becomes almost equal to BC. So their ratio will tend to 1. Okay. So in limiting case, we can write sin 0 degree is 0 and cos 0 degree is 1. So when we get these two values, we can find other four ratios. How? We know tan 0 degree. Tan 0 degree is sin 0 degree by cos 0 degree. So 0 by 1, that is 0. Now cosec 0 degree will be undefined because reciprocal of sin. Sec 0 degree will be 1 because 1 by 1 is 1. And cos 0 degree will be undefined because reciprocal of 0 is undefined. So we have found the trigonometric ratios of 0 degree. Next, when theta tends to 90 degree, then point C will move towards point B. Point C moves towards point B. As a consequence, length of BC tends to 0 and length of AC, this becomes almost equal to length of AB. Therefore, when theta tends to 90 degree, then sin theta. What is sin theta? Sin theta is AB by AC. Look, AC gets almost equal to AB. So what will be the ratio? AB by AC? The ratio will approach 1. Cos theta is BC by AC. Now as BC tends to 0, so what will its ratio tend to? Its ratio tend to 0 because AC has some definite length, but BC tends to 0, so their ratio tends to 0. So I get sin 90 degree is 1 and cos 90 degree is 0. So what will be tan 90 degree? Tan 90 degree is sin 90 degree by cos 90 degree, 1 divided by 0, undefined. cosec 90 degree reciprocal of sin 90 degree, this will be 1. Sec 90 will be undefined because reciprocal of 0 is not defined. And cot 90 degree will be cos 90 by sin 90, that is 0 by 1, that will be 0. So, we have derived geometrically all the values of the trigonometric ratios of 5 standard angles, 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90. Okay, in our next class, we will solve problems which are based on these standard ratios. Okay, till then, goodbye. Thank you.